Welcome back to my channel, guys. So today is gonna be like a kind of, it could be quite a long video. I'm just gonna put that out there now. I don't know, I could end up going through this really quick and it could be like a 7 minute video, or this could be a 17 minute video. So I'll just put that out there, have a look at the timestamp. So that is that. So basically what I have here is kind of like a, like an update video, and I'm going to show you all of last Friday's new releases, today's new releases, and I'm also going to unbox the April mystery kit, because I haven't done that, and rather than do that in its own video, I figured I would just throw it into this video. So yeah, this is kind of a little bit of an update on the shop. If you're wondering what new releases today, as of April, I've decided to make new releases a Monday thing. It works, I feel like it works out a lot better with my schedule. I work Tuesday through Saturday, so I have Sunday, Monday off. So that means that I can spend Sunday working on new releases, getting everything finalized, getting everything done, and then Monday I can fill whatever new release orders come in on Monday, whatever that might be. And I can also do designing for the next week and things like that, because with it being on a Friday, it ends up Thursday nights, I've usually got quite a bit to do, so I figured it'd be better on a Sunday night when I don't have to get up and go anywhere on Monday. So yes, that just works out a little bit better for me, and yeah, so that is that. So I think I will get, I'll leave the April mystery kit and you can stick around and see that if you would like. I'll go through Friday's new releases, what came out on Friday, and then what is coming out today. So it'll be up when you see this. I'm kind of probably going to put the video up at the same time that I'll pop up the new releases. And also, I'm currently, there's a sale going on for today only. It is MSC20, so for Modern Stationery Co. 20 for 20% off any order. It is for Modern Stationery Co.'s birthday. I'm a vendor on their site, so she kind of put feelers out and said, do any of my vendors want to participate in a sale? So she's got quite a few shops going in a sale at the moment. I am one of them. That is the code for 20% off, MSC20. I'll try and pop it on the screen. So that's 20% off whatever you want today. And also check out her Instagram as well, Modern Stationery Co., for all the other shops as part of the sale. They've all, not all, but most, quite a few shops have contributed a code. So check that out, if you want some more deals. But that is one that's currently running for the shops. That was another reason I wanted to throw that into this video. But yeah, we'll get started. First, you've got your two May monthly kits. You've got the May personal kit and the May, just the full Erin Condren May monthly view kit. So this is our personal kit here. We have super pretty, super May colored. I might even zoom in a little bit and just move the page as needed. You can, it's like quite hard to see these here as they're quite light colors, but you can see them. It was something I was so worried about while designing, but when it's the printed version, you can totally see it. So that's that. I did actually turn these into date strips. They were like just blank for whatever, but I feel like the kit kind of needed them, so I changed them to date strips, and we'll see how that goes, and then I might decide to try and move in more. I've kind of been toying with the idea of it being a two-page kit and having more, but I don't know, we'll see. And then you've got your six full boxes here, and then you've got your like sidebar one here. You can pop whatever you want in there. It's slightly like light, like whited out in the middle, only slightly, as you can see there, just so if you wanted to write on it, you're not writing directly on pattern, but if you wanted a pattern, it still looks like one. Because I know I don't write on it. You've got your little event labels, event boxes, mini icons, and some little mini flags there. So pretty basic setup for the personal monthly kit. These ones are made specifically for the, what are they? The Aussie Planner Chick inserts, but I'm sure they fit quite a few others. I'm not sure. You'd have to have a little look and play around. So then that's that there, and then you also have the May monthly for the Erin Condren. So I will open this up. This is a three-page thing, and then you have a little freebie that changes with each month based on like what the days not in the month and the holidays and things like that. So this is your freebie. You've got a full box here for one of the days not in the month, and then a three box here for the other days not in the month. Then you've got Memorial Day, Cinco de Mayo, and Labor Day. And I figured because I was including like a holiday for like only like three states of Australia, not even all of Australia, I would include, generally I don't include American holidays because I do sell to some Americans, but my main customer base is Australian. But I figured I'm putting in like one that's only for like half of Australia. I can put in the US ones as well. And I don't know, like, is Cinco de Mayo particularly in America? I don't know. So I just included them, and then you've got Memorial Day there, and then I feel like there was, no. Is that it? I feel like I'm missing one now. No, there's Mother's Day, but I did a Mother's Day full box. I'm like, there's a big one that I'm missing. So that's that. So that's your little freebie there. That's what changes every month. The rest is the same. On this page, you've got your May bar for the left side, which has like Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday. You've got your date dots. You've got paydays, bill dues, some flags, and then some strips to mark like time in like spanses of time. So there's that. You have your second bar for the right side. You've got a little bit of deco here. You've got your three decorative full boxes, but one is a Mother's Day box, and then the background says love you, love you. So I thought that was actually really cute. And again, kind of hard to see. You can kind of see it there, but it is clear on the printed version. And then you have icons down here. So that is that. And then you have your sidebar sticker, your sidebar box that goes on the bottom, and then you can put whatever you want on that, whether it be a quote, whether it be a deco, whether it be an event or something. You can stick whatever you want down there. And this here, this one here, I've showed it before. You can pop a header over this one, like say over this particular hexagon. It'll completely cover the hexagon, and it'll fit perfectly in the middle of the whited out space, so that you can like break this up however you want it, rather than, because you might have six bills 1 month, three events and two to-dos, and then the next month you might have eight to-dos, three bills, like it'll change. So I figured you could pop whatever you wanted there, rather than having them in like particular little boxes. You've got some event labels, some event like kind of bigger quarter boxes for bigger things, and then you've got some like solid color like event, like time strips there. So that is your May monthly kit, which I'm kind of in love with. I love the like baby blue. I just think it's so pretty. So that's that though. So that's the two monthly ones that came out on Friday. And then this is the kit that came out on Friday. It is the Happy Soul Kit, based off a full box which says, take time to do what makes your soul happy. So it is the same background papers as this, but then the clip art is different. So I've kind of mixed and matched a little bit to create a kit that I love, which I love, love doing. And this is the kit that was the first kit that I released glitter headers with. And then as of today, most have glitter headers now. I've added glitter headers to quite a few of them. So this is the kit. So these are your full boxes. So you've got a double box here, which is the bicycle, which I just think is so cute. You've got the hat, the glasses, which I love these. They're like so like 70s, 80s. I love that. You've got the like girl carrying the bag. And then you've got the full girl up here. They're not meant to go together. I want to clear that up. They're not meant to like fit. They're meant to be two separate things. Just by the way, I thought her legs and her feet in the bag were really cute, so I wanted them on their own, and then I wanted her on her own. And I just think some people might think they're meant to be a double box, but they're not. They're meant to be separate. And then you've got this one, which is like the lavender sprig there. And then you've got the quote box, which says, take time to do what makes you so happy. So that's that. And it's so pretty. I love this kit. Like, I'm in love with this kit. I'm loving the kits that I'm designing lately. Like, that sounds so like up myself, but I've fallen in love with like every single one, and I'm so happy with them. So then you have your full box checklists, your washi, so you've got your bottom washi here and your washi strips and a couple of extra washi strips in here. If I can get them up. There, that's those. And then you have your headers and little things. Then you have your half boxes. Part of me was like, can I just do all solid boxes again? But I think some people really like having patterned ones. So I did it, but instead of just doing plain patterns, I kind of put some clip art in behind them to make them a little bit different. So you've got the shoe in that one there. That one is plain. You've got like a sunflower there, and then you've got like a little bee or a fly, some sort of insect. I don't know, it looks cute. So stuff that's not particularly in the full boxes, but it is in the deco, so it kind of pulls everything in. And then you have your deco and your, your basics, your deco and your functional items there. So you've got your deco here, icons, bilges, weekend banner, weekly ombres. So that's a little look at your deco there. See how like you've got the shoe and the stuff that's not necessarily a full item in the full boxes, but they're having them in the deco and in the half boxes pulls them in. And you've got that one again, a little bit more deco up here. Date covers, flags, date dots, three heart checklists, three point checklists, habit trackers, and then your like just non-full box checklists. And then you have your glitter headers, which your glitter headers are $2 on their own, or they are free if you buy the full kit. They're just an addition to the full kit that doesn't cost any more. So that's that. So technically it's free, but it's just like kind of the discount is just a little bit better than if you were to buy them all singularly. I think if you buy everything singularly, that's So it's about $25.50, I think, or $26 or something along those lines. And it's $20 for the full kit. So you're just saving a few extra dollars if you want it all to buy the full kit. So that's that. So that's the glitter headers there. So that's super cute. And I'm in love. And I can't wait to do this spread. I have it set for like May-ish time. So that's that. So those are the three releases that came out on Friday. So they were available in the shop all weekend. But if you haven't picked them up now, today's a great day with that birthday code. So that's that. And then this is what's coming out today, or is coming out when you see this video. So I decided to add glitter headers for three other kits. I just wanted to do the glitter headers in like sets of seven. You only get it once, but you get it in a set of seven. Which, I don't know why I didn't just do it that way, but it is two sheets, so I'll quickly go over that. And then another notes pages. Not necessarily for May, but I think I'll come out with a new one, maybe one or two every single month, just so that there is one there for the month if you wanted it. But it's not necessarily for May. You might want to save this for like August or something. It's just the one that I'm releasing along with May stuff. So the first three like glitter headers, you've got these other ones for the Easter kit. These won't have their own listing, they'll just be added into the already live listing. So you just have to go in and like select which sheet you want if you've already purchased the kit and now you want the glitter headers. So that is those there. And then you've got the Sunday Feels glitter headers here, and then you have the Fall Feels glitter headers here. So that is all of the glitter headers that came out for the different kits, because I figured why not, they don't take very long. So that's that. And then you've got your full, like, I don't know what to call these, like full set glitter headers. There is two pages of them, but it won't be the same as buying two single pages. It'll be $6 for the two, so you're saving $1, but still, that's better than buying both of them separately. So you get all 16 colours, you get 7 of all 16 colours, so you've got like the first 8 here and the first 8, the first 8 here and the second 8 there, so that's all 16 multicolour there, all just so you don't have to buy, like, I do realise the way I had them before singularly, they're a bit awkward in numbers, but they're meant to like work out if you buy bulk a bit. So this is just if you just want 7 of the headers and you don't kind of, and you use all 7 all at once kind of thing. The other ones are a little bit more buy as you need, like depending on how you use glitter headers. This is just if you just use like three different versions of 7. So that's that. And then the last new release is the May notes page, like I said. So not a lot today. I did want to have the Mother's Day kind of sort of kit out, but I didn't want to rush it. I wanted to, again, love it like I love the rest. So I'm going to release that next week if you are interested. Keep your eyes peeled. Instagram, Facebook group, as always. So this is your notes page. I don't think I've really, besides my, like, January notes page video, I haven't really gone over this, like, quickly. So you have two bars here, which, basically are the same as the bars in the monthly spread, but I'll kind of show you how I use them. Let me show you how I kind of use this. You can look at the January video. It's quite a long video though, because my notes page videos take quite a long time, but this is my kit. I usually pull in a lot of EC stickers, and this is the first time I pull in a lot of like multicolor and a lot of like characters and different things like that to make the spread, but that's that. So I kind of got, you've got the two bars that kind of go on the top and on the bottom there, just to kind of give you like a little banner. I've done it as well with like EC's versions of it. Where are we at? So EC does a similar one where they're a bit skinnier, which is kind of where a little bit taking the inspiration from, but adding other things that I needed, and other things that might be more functional for you guys. And then you've got some like event boxes and bigger ones, so for different size events that happened in the month. And then you've got these bars here, which I use to kind of break up the sections of the month. So I'll do like events. I'll usually do like a what I was watching, like what I started watching, if I finished watching anything, if a show came back on, stuff like that, stuff I was watching for the month. So I'll break it up into different portions. And then you've got this, which I don't ever really use, but it's something I wanted to add in there for you guys. So if you break them up in like a to buy section, a to do section, if you do these like as an actual planning for the month, I do them in Rewind, so I don't normally need these. But you've got to buys, to do's, birthdays, events, so they can just help you label the different sections if you make sections like I do. Or you can also like make little checklists, or a to buy checklist, a to do checklist, a birthdays checklist. If you have that many, you need to keep them in check and like make a list and keep track of the presents you bought, whatever it might be. Or you can just write your own header on top of the to do list. So that's those. And then I've got this other little flag, which you can just put like some decorative thing on it, write a quote. It just gives a little bit more, I don't know, shape and a little bit more diversity to the spread, I find, with that flag there instead of having just boxes. So I quite like it. And I like this format for now. If anybody has anything they want to add or change, let me know, because I have been thinking of making these slightly skinnier, so that would give me a little bit more room. So, let me know what you think. But that is the notes page format. Again, two pages, I'm almost definite, is $6. Usually if stuff is a set of two, like you have to buy it in a set of two, I discount it, so it's not like, yeah. So you feel a little bit better about having to buy two sheets. I don't know, I swear they're $6. But that's just off the top of my head. So that is those. If they're not $6, I feel like I'm going to make them $6 because they should be $6. that is what's coming out. That is what came out today. So that is all the new releases there for the past, I guess, weekend, you could say. The next new releases now will be on Monday. Don't worry, I won't be doing any more on Friday. Zoom back out a little bit. So that is all of that. And then now let's quickly go in. So now, I don't mind if you guys feel like clicking off the video. That is new releases for this week, this weekend, and that's new releases. If that's what you came to see, I don't mind you clicking off, but I will be unboxing the April mystery kit now. So I'm going to zoom back in. This is the April mystery kit that was actually pre-released, I guess you could say, at the Brisbane Planner Market, so I had a few available there, and then it came out the Monday after that. So a couple people got their hands on it, I think without even realizing it was the mystery key. I didn't really have it marked. So that is that. But then it was live in the shop for, I think I left it there for actually over a week by accident because I didn't realize I took it down. So that's that. But it is like, I actually kind of really like this kit. And I haven't seen anybody use this clip art. So I was like, yes, this is gorgeous. I'm in love. Wrong way. I feel like I've never done that. So this is what I call like my fairies kit. I don't know. That's what I've saved it under fairy, like as that. But it's like a little bit of, it's a little bit more of like a springtimey kit, but I also just think it's really, really pretty and like feminine, and I don't know. I feel like it would just go well in April and May, even though it's not spring here. I still quite like it. So you have these, and the quote box says, "Leave room in your garden for fairies to dance." And then you've got like the little fairy there, you've got some ladybugs, some cute little flowers, and a little mushroom. And then the fairy in the jar. I thought the jar was really, really cute, so I had to include that. Then you've got your full box checklist there, which from now on will always be like you saw in the Happy Soul kit. For the most part, they will always just be broken up into the four different colours. I think I like that better than the patterned, I think. We'll see. Let me know what you guys think, but I think it makes the spread look a bit better and it helps with colour blocking and things like that. So that's that. Unless it's like a really pretty pattern that I have to include that has a lot of colour in it, then that'll be it. And then you've got your washi strips, your bottom washi, and then your extra washi strips here. So that is those. Your headers and your little things. This is your first kind of glance at the colours, I guess. Really pretty colours. I'm in love. And also from as of May, it wasn't this month because obviously I designed and cut and did this month quite a while ago. But as of May, they will all have glitter headers as well. Same price, same as like full kit now. I'll just be including glitter headers. And you've got your half boxes here. So you've got some pattern ones and some solids. And you've got your event labels, stitch banners, things like that. And then you've got your two functional deco sheets. You've got deco up here. Icons, weekend banner, same gist, weekly checklists, date covers, an extra little deco. I love this mushroom, it's so cute. Date dots, flags, what are they? Habit trackers, checklists, all that good stuff that you saw in the other kids. Same format as the kids. I've been toying with the idea of slightly changing those back two pages to include a full box, but I'm not quite sure where. I don't know. Let me know. Would you like that? Just let me know. So that is the April mystery kit. Gives you an idea of kind of the designs and stuff. I try and keep the mystery kits. I don't have anybody designing for me, so I don't really get completely exclusive designs, but I try to keep them as different from kits you can already buy. And you get a glance at the clipper. I do have a preview. It's not completely, it's like the actual listing picture shows pieces of the clip art. So you can obviously, if you can recognize it, it might already be in a kit. But I always try and find the most random and clip arts I can find for mystery kits because they are a mystery. So I don't want them to clash with a kit you may already have, if that makes any sense. But I don't have someone designing for me exclusively, or I don't do custom exclusive designs. I don't commission anybody to do them just yet. So it's just about pulling from like the deep dark corners of Etsy that other shop owners haven't found yet. So that is that. And I actually really like the way this kit turned out. Again, not really to season, but it's not really like, for me, this isn't like me trying to be like spring summery. It's just a really pretty kit. I wasn't really thinking about the seasons when I designed that particular one, so I hope that's okay with you guys, all of my Aussie ones. So yes, but that is everything for this video. New releases, April mystery kit. New releases are from on Mondays from now on. They will be, for the most part, they will be every week, except it's usually about the second or third Monday of the month, depending on that, will be the mystery kit. There'll be no releases that week, just the mystery kit. This month, it is the 10th, so is it actually next week? Okay, it's actually next week. So there might be a sneaky little Mother's Day kit in with it because I want to get the Mother's Day kit up. But other than that, it normally will just be the mystery kit on its own. So that is everything for this video. Remember the sale, that'll be, I'll try and have it on the screen and then I'll leave it in the description below. That is for today only. If you are interested, 20% off your order, go for it. And I will see you guys in my next video. Bye.